Hello, in this video I'm going to show you how to import leads that you've received in CSV format. If you need to brush up on CSV files and how to manipulate them, please watch the video titled CSV File Tutorial and then come back and watch this video. Most outbound telemarketing companies receive their leads via CSV files from different sources like websites or inbound call centers. And most companies work with a handful of outside sources that send them leads. The problem in traditional systems has always been mapping outside CSV files to in-house systems. This usually takes weeks of programming and costs a few thousand dollars. In direct results telemarketing, we wanted to solve this problem. So we created this cool new program that allows you to map your CSV file by simple drag and drop operation and save it as a template for future use. So you set up your CSV mapping once in the system admin menu, and then your non-technical staff can use your preset mapping to import CSV files very easily. I'm going to show you how that works. It's real simple. To get started, all you need is the CSV file that you want to import in whatever format you received it. Okay, I'm going to take a look at the CSV file that I received from my inbound call center. It's right here. I'm going to open this in Notepad. And here it is. We see that it has a header record plus a number of leads, and that the columns are separated by the pipe character. So every time we receive leads from this particular inbound call center, in our case study, the inbound call center is called Live Interactive. So anytime we receive leads from Live Interactive, we expect it to be in the same format. So now I'm going to go to our direct results telemarketing, and I have the CSV file template screen open. You can reach this screen from System Admin, then CSV file templates, and it says import leads below it. In CSV file templates screen, we're telling the system how to import this kind of CSV file, how to map the fields to direct results telemarketing system fields, and what default values to enter into the leads each time this kind of file is imported. It's important to understand that at this stage, we're not actually importing the file. We're only setting parameters for importing this particular type of CSV file, and we're going to name this set as a template and save it, so that at a later time a call center administrator may use our pre-saved template to easily import this kind of CSV file. We start by loading the actual CSV file that we've received from our lead source. The import file field here, we'll go click on browse, and I select the actual CSV file here, click open. Now we have to specify what delimiter is used in this file, and we know from looking at it earlier in Notepad that it used pipe. Now select the lead type. I'm going to select infomercial because these leads were generated through airing a 2-minute spot. Source specifies the lead source. It identifies the company or entity that actually sends us these leads or the CSV file. In our case study, these leads were sent to us from a third-party inbound call center called Live Interactive. So I'm going to enter that here. That means every time these leads are imported, the system will automatically enter Live Interactive and set the lead type to infomercial. Client ID and campaign ID are only used if you perform telemarketing services for other clients other than your own company. So in this case, we're going to leave this blank. Now you have to specify the call center these leads will be assigned to every time they're imported. When leads are imported in DRT, they need to be assigned to a call center at the time of import. We can specify how to handle this assignment using this drop-down menu. And we have three choices. First choice is assigned to default call center of user importing. This means that at the time of importing, the system will assign the leads to the call center of the person who's performing the import. So if the call center administrator from Arizona call center is importing, the leads will be assigned to Arizona. But if a call center administrator from California is importing, those leads will be assigned to California. This is the default setting, and in most cases, what you want to leave it as. The second option is assign to specific call center. With this option, you select the call center that the leads will be assigned to here in this screen. This will be regardless of the person who is doing the import. For instance, if you select California here, and it confirms our selection by showing it here, these leads will always be assigned to California when they're imported. The third option is map to call center specified in import file. For this option, the call center ID must be included in the import file, in the CSV file, for every row. In other words, we're saying that there's a column in the CSV file that contains the call center ID to assign these leads to. This option is useful if leads are pre-assigned by another process and allows one batch of leads to be assigned to multiple call centers. When you select this option, a call center ID field is added to a list of available mapping fields. So I'm going to go back and select our first option, assigned to default call center of user importing. Now you click this button here to actually load this CSV file into this panel. So this loaded a row of the CSV file into this panel, and we can page through. This is the top row, and if we go back and look at our CSV file, we see that the top row was customer ID, first name, last name, and you see that here. If I click next, it shows me the next row in the file, Carlos, and so I can continue to page through and view the leads, the actual leads in the CSV file. Now what I have to do is drag and drop these leads to this mapped value column. So I find the easiest way to do this, if there is a header record, to select that and then simply start dragging. So customer ID is going to map to my customer ID here. So I drag it and drop it there. First is first name, last name, address, apartment goes to address 2, city goes to city, so forth. Zip code is very important, must be specified. That's what the system uses to determine customer's time zone and to avoid calling the customer in the middle of the night. Phone number, obviously very important for a telemarketing company. Alt phone, it's usually a cell phone. Email. Now if you make a mistake, and for instance if you put the email in the website field and you want to reset this, all you do is highlight it and hit the delete key on your keyboard, and it removes it and puts it back here. Now as you're dragging and dropping, notice that it removes them from here, so you know what you've already assigned and what still remains to be assigned. I'm skipping time zone because the system doesn't require it. It's automatically going to determine the time zone of the lead using the zip code. Few other fields, last purchase is included here. This is the last time this particular customer purchased something, and we have a field for that in DRT, last trans date. And last amount is last purchase amount or last trans amount. These are useful when assigning leads to determine the quality of the lead. Obviously the more recent purchases could have a higher value, and higher previous purchases could have a higher value lead. We're going to skip these two. We don't need them in the system. Now I'm going to assign a name to this template, and I'm going to name it after the source, and I'm going to hit save. So here I'm presented with an error. System is telling me that at least one of the following columns must be marked as required: zip code, phone, alt phone, or email. So when we import leads, we need to tell the system at least one field that's required. In most cases, that's phone. And to make this required, this is saying that all of these fields are optional right now. To make one or more of them required, you simply click on it and it makes it required. Zip code is another thing that you generally want to make required, so you can determine the time zone of the customer. So I'm going to mark those two as required. Now I'm going to save. It saved it, it assigned the template ID of 101, and we're done. It was as easy as that, just drag and drop. So now this lead source and this type of file is available to be imported by our call center administrators or call center managers very easily. They don't have to go through mapping anymore because we've done it for them here. All they have to do is select the correct template when they go to import leads, and we cover that in the next video, how to import leads based on these predefined templates. I'm going to exit this. Now, if you want to make changes to the CSV template, it's very easy. Go back to the program. In this case, click on Load Existing Template. We're going to load the one that we just set up, Live Interactive. So here we are reminded that loading existing templates display position of each mapped column in the above grid. To view actual column names, load a CSV file in the same format. All this means is that the system is showing you this is how you mapped it, but since we haven't mapped the CSV file, we're not seeing names, we're just seeing positions. If you want to actually see the names, click Browse and select one of the CSV files and click Load, and here we have it, the actual names, what's required, exactly the way we left it before. And here you're able to make changes if you need to, and save it again. This concludes this video. The next video will show you how to import leads into the system using existing templates. Thank you.